What can we say? On the whole, this motor leaves very good impressions. It has a really cool performance. You need to get used to the controllability a bit and probably add a couple of options to make it warmer for the driver. But taking into consideration the fact that this development is completely domestic, the emotions are purely positive. No, we're not crazy, and this is not a bike news and not even a test drive. This is a report about very talented, even gifted people who do unbelievable things that unfortunately don't get your attention. This is Evgeny Duyunov, and this is an electric bicycle with a motor that theoretically allows to develop the speed of up to 250 km per hour. And one of the entertainment internet resources there was a post about it saying that in Yakutia, a miracle bicycle has been assembled with out-of-this-world performance. In fact, it has been accelerated up to 100 km per hour so far, and there's a geographic mistake too. It all took place in Zelenograd, in some rented premises of the former Research and Development Institute. We started working on the hub motor on February 4, 2015. We got the idea to implement our developments, the products that would be available for every customer, because we already had the experience of making drives for electric cars, and gradually, we got the understanding that the same should be done for two-wheeled vehicles. The same last name is not a mere coincidence. Dmitry Alexandrovich is Evgeny's father, an inventor, developer, project manager, in general the brains of this small company named ASNPP. The induction hub motor is a result of his work, both manual and intellectual. Induction motors are used everywhere in industry, everywhere, but they haven't been applied for vehicles. Why? Firstly, can be explained by the absence of power electronics that could be used for turning direct current into alternating current. It's the first reason. Let's explain it one step at a time. First of all, what is an induction motor? This is briefly how it's made. The current is sent through the winding. When the phases are switched, the field is turned and the magnetic induction vector is turned. In synchronous motors, the rotor turns with the same frequency as the resulting magnetic current vector made by the stator. In induction motors, the rotor rotates slower, and the attractive effort torque is made by the shorter turns instead of the magnets. And now about the second reason, which in fact explains the innovation presented by the inventor. The thing is that all attempts to make the induction hub motor failed, because motors with standard winding have low starting torque and low specific capacity. We have developed a new kind of winding that allows to get high starting torque, lower inrush current and high torque even in standard motors with standard winding changed to our winding. That's how the idea of trying it in a hub motor appeared. Without your background knowledge, it's difficult to understand, but we'll try to explain. There are two most widespread types of winding. Their shape is similar to delta and star. In fact, that's what they named. Duyunov and his colleagues decided to combine these two types. That's how the so-called Slavyanka appeared. It allows to get the electromagnetic motor performance that has never been seen before. The development has wide application, from cars to heavy military machinery. Such motors are energy efficient, durable, and not expensive to produce. The technology has already been tested on four-wheeled vehicles. It was successful. So successful that there was an attempt to steal the innovation secret. No wonder. With the winding developed by Dmitry Duyunov, the motor outperformed the latest Tesla developments. And what a car it was mounted on! The Zaporozhets was made by Sergei Velchev. He made it in 1 month. He bought and made it, and the result was so successful that in the terms of distance and speed range, it was able to take part in the Kyiv Monte Carlo car rally. Moreover, it wasn't outplayed by all other cars. On top of that, it made it to the finish line, and all of it despite the fact that two stages were annulled, because it demonstrated quite good results there. And when it arrived to the appointed place, there was no charger there. So it covered 640 kilometers on a single charge. And then this car was a bit dragged at the parking. They hoped that it would be repaired where the other cars are serviced. In other words, where there would be all conditions for the detailed study and copying the technology. But the team didn't fall for the trick. They took all the secrets safe back home. Sure thing, the story is more than interesting for the car industry. Apart from the efficiency and durability, the idea is about the possibility of making a car with 4-leading independent wheels with all resulting advantages. But we'll get back to our bicycle. It was brought to the Eco Week exhibition. The reaction of the visitors was predictable. A lot of people would like to have such a two-wheeled vehicle. They were interested when it would be launched in a market, where it could be bought and what the price would be. And the potential clients are ready to buy this vehicle online now. As we see, there is a demand. So what is the stumbling block? It's hard to talk about batch production or mass production yet, because people want it, people are interested. But does the industry want to do it? Bicycle producers, motor producers, where are they? But still, there are some small enterprises and a certain amount of manufacturers and producers that want to work on it. The task is very simple – to find these people. In other words, the innovation itself doesn't raise any questions. We even know how to sell bicycles. And this is given that the company doesn't work on developing vehicles, but rather the induction motor technologies. But people are hesitant to use them, and it's not because of the financial issues, but mere red tape. There's a contradiction. The design engineers can do it, the developers can do it, but don't want to. Why? Class conflict. They say, what for? There is an owner, we'll help him make money, he won't share it with us. We'll be doing work, taking our time for the same salary, and so on and so forth. And the owner lives in parallel universe. He's up there on Olympus, and the people are down on Earth. That's how the contradiction appears. Some don't want, the others can't. But despite this, the bicycles made using the technologies of Dmitry Alexandrovich are bound to appear. If so, it's reasonable to ask how much they will cost. I can only speak about the production cost. But if I announce the production cost now, it will be difficult for me to agree with the salespeople. The only thing that can be said with certainty is that it will be much cheaper than the permanent magnet technology. I think that there is not much time left until we get the answer to this question. And in the nearest month, we'll be able to announce these figures. And so far, the talks are on and the technology is forging ahead. Though skilled in business, but still first and foremost, they are inventors. For instance, they're working on making their own controller, an intermediary device between the induction motor and wheels. Of course, all of it is done at their own expense, that very microfinance. And there's also their own technologies for producing more effective and safe accumulator batteries with high capacity, as well as the dozen of other super promising know-how. But it's probably another story.